Hello children, welcome to the online session of Sri Gokulam Public School Guruvayur. Children, we were discussing journal entries. Today we will discuss about some special journal entries. You have to copy the same in your accountancy notebook. Okay, so here are some special journal entries. The first one is goods given as charity or goods donated. So if we have purchased some goods and those goods were given as charity, then the journal entry you have to pass is charity or donation account debited to purchase account. So note down, it is a special entry. So when the goods are given as charity, you have to write down charity or donation account debited to purchase account. Now, the second special entry is distribution of goods as samples. Sometimes the business, as an advertisement, they give some samples of the goods. So, those goods which are distributed as sample, for that, the journal entry passed will be advertisement or samples account debited to purchase account. So, goods is being distributed. So, here purchase will be credited. Okay, next entry, special entry, is loss on stock by theft or fire. So due to fire or due to theft, some stock have been loss or stock. So in that case, the journal entry goes this way: loss of stock by theft or fire account debited, because loss means it's an expenses or losses should be debited as per the rule. So, this will be debited to purchase account because some of the goods or stock is been lost. So, purchase will be credited. Now, drawing account. You know what is drawing. So, if a proprietor or a investor, if a proprietor have invested some withdrawn some amount for his personal purpose, that is known as drawing. So, if there is a cash drawing, then the journal entry will be drawing account debited to cash account. This entry you are very familiar. Now, when goods are withdrawn, so the journal entry will be drawing account debited to purchases account. So, just understand that when it is a cash drawing, cash will be credited, and if it is goods which is drawn by the partner for his personal use, then it will be to purchase account. Next is purchase and sale of fixed asset. See children, you now are, I think you are, you know what are the list of fixed assets. Okay, machinery, land, building, motor vehicle. So these are the list or some items related to fixed asset. So if you are purchasing or selling a fixed asset, see, purchase of goods and purchase of fixed asset is two different concept. So if you are purchasing a fixed asset, you have to use the word the asset which you have purchased. Suppose you have purchased the machinery, then you will write machinery account debited. Okay, if you are purchasing land, then land account debited. So only when you know the items which come under fixed asset, then only you will be able to post this. And if it is goods which is purchased, then purchase account will be debited. So only that thing you have to remember. That is, if it is goods purchased, then purchase account will be debited. If it is fixed asset that is purchased, fixed asset will be debited. And as you are purchasing something, you have to pay the cash. So if you are paying the cash, so the entry will be to cash. If you are paying this amount for purchase of fixed asset in check, so you have to credit the bank account. So remember, if it is cash you are paying, so to cash. If you are paying through check, then to bank account will be credited. And if it is a credit purchase, then to supplier's account. Okay, so this is the journal entry for purchase of fixed asset. Now what about sale of fixed asset? In when you sell something, you will receive the cash. So if you are receiving cash, cash will be debited because cash is an asset. Asset increases, you know, it should be debited. And if you are receiving check by the other party, then bank account will be debited. Okay. And here, if the purchase is a credit purchase, then the purchaser's name will be debited. Okay. We know that sometimes it may happen that purchase, when we sell something, it may be on loss. So, if it is, we sold the fixed asset at a loss, then loss will be debited. So, loss on sale of fixed asset will be debited. And what is moving out of the business? It is fixed asset. What is decreasing from our asset? Fixed asset. So, to fixed asset account. Okay. To gain or sale of fixed asset. So, children, why I have put a star in front of this is when you sell a fixed asset, there may be sometimes a loss or it may be a profit. So, either of this may appear in your question. So, as per the question, you have to understand whether it is a loss or whether it is a profit, and then you post this entry. Anyway, when you sell a fixed asset, cash or check is coming in, or that is purchaser. Purchaser means what? Debtor. So, debtor has been created. And what is going out or what is decreasing? The fixed asset is decreasing. So, fixed asset will be credited. So, with the rule of debit and credit, we have posed this journal entry. Now, the sixth special item is expenditure on installation of machinery and on construction of building. Suppose we have purchased a machinery and we don't know how to install that machinery. So we have to take the help of some expert members to install that machinery. So we have to pay some extra additional expenditure we have to spend on installation of that machinery. Same way, if we are going for a construction of a building, in these two cases, the journal entry will be related to debiting the machinery account because these expenses are known as capital expenditure. Okay, so whenever you charge for a capital expenditure, you will have to debit in first case the machinery and in the second case the building. Because these are known as capital expenditure. You are installing this machinery so that it will give you benefit for the coming future. So, such expenditure which you make for the progress or for the improvement of the production which gives you a benefit for a long time, such expenditure are known as capital expenditure. So, you have to debit the fixed asset or the machinery on which the installation is taking place. Okay, just note down this in your text notebook. The next special entry is miscellaneous or sundry expenses. We know that in a business there are many petty expenses. Petty expense means small expenses like postage, stamp on stamp papers or on stamp you have to spend a small expenses, or traveling expenses are there. So all these small expenses are incurred in a business. These expenses involve small amount that are not material in nature. Therefore, such expenses are recorded as miscellaneous or sundry expenses. So, what will be the journal entry in this case? Miscellaneous or sundry expenses account debited to cash account. You know that expenses or losses should be debited. If it increases, you should debit those expenses. And because this is an expenses, on that you have to spend the cash. Cash is an asset which decreases, you have to credit it. Okay, so with the rule of debit and credit, you will debit the expenses, and because cash is decreasing, you will credit the cash account. Now, those were the special entry. Now, here is some adjustment entries. Okay, please note down this. First one is closing stock. So as you know that whenever we have a we know that accounting period is divided into small intervals. So when we start our business on 1st April 2019, it on 31st March 2020, it will close. Closing date is 31st March 2020. So that is on those days, on 31st March 2020, when you close this books of account, you will get the closing stock. Okay, those closing stock is an asset for the next financial year. So this will be regarded as the asset which should be debited. Okay, and what will be credited here? It's the trading account. See children, account was missed to be posted over here, so it is a C. Okay, now the next special entry in this regard is outstanding expenses. Outstanding expenses means what? The expenses which we were not paid. Okay, suppose the labor or wages we have not paid. So that is our outstanding, that is the liability. So wages will be debited to outstanding account. Our liability increases. So what you should do with our liability if it increases? So you should credit it. Now next item is prepaid or unexpired expenses. Prepaid means something paid in advance. Suppose rent of next year or next month, we have paid it in advance. Okay, so prepaid expenses should be debited to the relevant expenses account. It may be rent, it may be insurance, so whatever it is given in your question, as per that, that expenses name should be written over here. Next one is accrued income or income earned but not received. It is the interest income which have been earned, okay, but we have not yet received that income. So in that case, what we will do? Accrued income will be debited to income account. So income may be an interest on the loan given. So this will be the journal entry which you have to follow. Please note down in your accountancy notebook. Next is income received in advance or unearned income. So anything received in advance is your liability. So if your liability increases, what are you supposed to do? Credit it. So rent received account debited. You have received a rent in advance. So rent account, whatever received in advance, that particular account will be debited to rent received in advance account. Now depreciation. Depreciation means reduction in the value of asset due to its continuous use. So depreciation is your expenses. Expenses, if it increases, you have to debit it. So depreciation will be debited, and because the depreciations are charged on the fixed asset will be credited. Next is interest on capital. Interest on capital is amount which a firm should pay to its partners or the person who have invested their capital. So the journal entry goes this way: interest on capital account debited to capital account. From the firm's point of view, interest on capital is a expenses for them, so that will be debited. Next is interest on drawing. It is opposite of interest on capital. It is an item which reduces your capital it is an item which is good for your firm, because interest on drawing the company is receiving. So capital account will be debited to interest on drawing account. Okay, so these are some of the adjustment entries. So in today's class we have discussed both special journal entries and adjustment entries. Note down this in your accountancy notebook and study it well. Okay, so for today this is all. Meet you in the next class, but don't forget to attend the test paper attached. So children, goodbye.